What's up, guys? The Flying Tech here. Today we're going to be checking out the Furibee GT 215mm Fire Dancer. So let's get right into it. Wow, guys, check it out. Look how beautiful this is. You get these tri-blade props and they are just gorgeous. I love how it matches everything with the body. The motors match. So sweet looking right out of the box. Now, as I mentioned, this is a 215mm. It is an X frame, all carbon fiber. This has a very rugged design. I mean, it feels really stiff. I still definitely advise that you tighten all these up before flight though. The flight controller is an Omnibus F4SD with Betaflight 3.2.0. It does have a built-in OSD. It does have a built-in SD card reader for the black box, which is pretty cool. This comes with 4-in-1 BLHeli ESCs that are 35 amp DShot. This unit comes with four 2400 kV brushless motors. They are unbranded, but I do love the color. Very nice indeed. All right, so the camera on this guy is a 140 degree field of view, 2 megapixel, 1080p with HD video. The camera can be moved up and down depending upon your particular flight style. 5.8 gigahertz transmitter boasts that it goes between 20, 200 and 600 milliwatts. You've got the button here for power and for frequency. And here are the LEDs for the particular frequency that you choose. The robust connector for the antenna is pretty unique. I like that a lot. It looks like that'll probably hang on there pretty good. Your FPV antenna is going to be a Pagoda 2, which I thought was pretty nice. Nice little name brand. One thing I definitely want to make mention of is the protection for the camera. These bars right here are super solid, and I'm telling you, it's going to take a real shot of luck to break this camera if you crash. So I thought that was pretty cool. Now this guy runs off a 3-cell, but it also takes up to a 6-cell battery. So I'm sure this guy is a screaming demon. Another thing I want to mention is the cable management on this guy. Check this out, the braided cables. Oh, I love it. This is so nice. It looks sleek. And it's definitely going to protect your wires in the event of a crash. For anyone wondering, this guy tips the scales at 330.4 grams. This kit in particular comes with two sets of props, some prop nuts, and a prop wrench. That is it. You don't get a battery with this model. You will have to buy that on your own. All right, let's connect it to the TX and then to Betaflight. So this particular model is the Fly Sky by Yixin. The way that you put this guy into bind mode, if you don't know, is very simple. All you have to do is hold down this button while pressing up the power button. Simple as that. So let's go ahead and do it. And now, as you can see, we're in bind mode. The next thing you want to do is locate that little pin right there and hold it down while you plug in the battery. That'll put the quad into bind mode as well. This quad has a feature, believe it or not, where you could change the VTX channel via the TX itself. Now, in theory, it sounds nice. I'll tell you what, I was having a really weird situation with this quad where anytime it would fail safe or anytime I would throttle up, it would switch the VTX channel. It was the weirdest thing I ever experienced. But, and I'd like to credit this to AndyRC. If you guys don't know who he is, you should check out his channel. I put a link in the description for it. Thank you, Andy. I really appreciate this. What you want to do is, you want to cut this wire here, this red wire. You can see it here. This is the second wire in on the pin from the right. You want to remove this wire because this is the wire that's causing all the problems with your VTX. So we're going to go ahead and do that right now. All right, guys, now that we're in Betaflight, let's go ahead and connect. All right, you want to make sure that it's on a flat level surface, and we're going to calibrate the accelerometer. So let's do that. There you go. Next, we'll move on to ports. You can see USB VCP and UART1 serial RX are enabled. If we move on to configuration, you can see that I have DShot 600, motor stop, disarm motors regardless of throttle. Nothing here has changed. I did change the craft name. This particular model is going to have the PPM RX input. Here I have these checked off: servo tilt, LED strip, air mode, OSD, anti-gravity, dynamic filter. And then for beeper configuration, it's all stock. Next on to power and battery. I have set the current meter source for none. It does come stock at onboard ADC. I changed the minimum cell values to 3.2 here and 3.2 here as well. PID tuning, this is all going to be stock. I haven't touched anything here. If you may want to change this, that's up to you. Next up, the receiver. Let's turn on the TX. As you can see, I'm definitely getting input from it.
move to modes. I have my modes set here this way. You may want to change that. You may want to set it to a different auxiliary. That's completely up to you, as well as the beeper. If we move on to OSD, you'll see that the elements I've chosen are just these few. I prefer to have a wide open screen when I fly. I don't like any kind of artificial horizons or anything like that. All right, guys, next we're gonna connect to BLHeli configurator. The first thing you wanna do is take your props off, make sure you do that, and then plug the battery into the quad. All right, let's go ahead and connect. Now you're gonna go ahead and go down to read setup. Now the only thing that you're gonna change here is this right here. You're gonna change it to medium low. The reason you wanna do this is because apparently this model has the what's called the flip of death. And by changing this right here, apparently will stop that from happening. Again, I have to credit AndyRC for this one. Next, you're gonna go ahead and press right setup. I already did, so I'm not going to. And then we can disconnect. All right, guys, the next thing to do is throw some props on it, take her in the field and test it out. So I'll meet you there. Now, I will be flying this guy today on a couple 4-cell 1300 mAh LiPos. We are at the park, so let's check it out. All right, guys, so it's pretty stable, as you can see. Hopping around a little bit there. I have it in stable mode. Let's do a quick punch out on it. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, this guy's got some power on him. Check out the yaw on this guy. Okay, not a bad yaw. All right, let's take it for an FPV flight. What do you say? Final thoughts. So my final thoughts on this quad are that it's actually a pretty awesome quad. Flies great. I mean, I'm no sport flyer, but I'm sure you guys can fly this thing a heck of a lot better than I can. I highly recommend, though, that you do that modification with the VTX wire. If you don't, it really does render this quad unflyable. It's definitely worth the money. It flies excellent. You saw I did a couple tricks with it. All right, guys, that's pretty much it for me. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, please leave a thumbs up. Leave all comments below. We love to get your comments. If you're new to the channel, please hit that subscribe button. And with that, guys, as always, happy flying.